B-Monster Laboratory here. Today we're going to use our Sparkfun MP3 Shield to make an Arduino motion-activated music player. We only need to add a couple extra components to our shield to make a motion-activated music player. I'm going to show you what those components are. I'll show you the build diagram. I'll also share the code with you. Let's begin.
You'll notice that as the music is playing, the motion sensor continues to detect movement. I looked into a couple ways to prevent movement from being detected during a song. I couldn't use interrupts because pin 2 and 3 was already in use in this shield. So I ended up putting a 1 minute delay on the motion sensor. And this is only noticeable if you're looking at the serial monitor or if you see the red LED blink. This was fine for my project because motion detection during a song didn't affect the song. But if you have any ideas on this, I'd love to hear about it in the comments down below. Here's a quick diagram for you. As you can see, the positive leg of my LED is connected to pin 10, and pin 5 is connected to the signal pin of my motion sensor. Now the ground pin and the 5 volt pin from the shield provide power to the positive and negative rails of my breadboard. And by the way, that is a 220 ohm resistor connecting the negative leg of the LED to the negative rail. I only have 10 songs on this SD card, but remember to rename them before you put them on your SD card. And you need to name them in an 8.3 format. For instance, track 001.mp3. If you need any more information about this, be sure to check the description below and click on the original video I did for this where I set up the shield. Now that I named them correctly, it's time to cut and paste these MP3 files to my SD card. Now it's time to insert my SD card into the shield. Now it's time to load the code to the breadboard here. And you're going to see once motion is detected, the red LED is going to come on and stay on for the 1 minute delay that I put in the code. Once the 1 minute delay is up, the red LED will go off and the sensor can then again detect motion. If motion is detected during a song, it doesn't affect the song. That song will still play all the way through. If you look at the serial monitor, you can see it's currently playing track 8. If the song was over, it would start playing track 6. But since the song's still playing, it's not affected. It's kind of annoying to see on a serial monitor, but I'm not going to have this attached to a serial monitor. I'm going to have it freestanding. Now this is the code that I've been using, and I wanted to mention a couple of things about it. You may want to make sure that it's set for 115-200 baud. And if you come down here to loop, I've got 10 tracks in this video. If you have 20 tracks on your SD card, you change it to 20. If you have 30, you change it to 30. I don't have a track 0, so what I did, if the random number equals 0, the random number equals random number plus 1. That way it's never selecting track 0, which isn't on there. And if I come down here, this is my 1 minute delay. If you don't want a 1 minute delay, take it out. If you want a 2 minute delay, put 120,000 there. And by the way, I'll have this code posted on the Facebook page. Well, this is what my project looks like. I think I'm going to create a box to contain everything in. But yeah, this thing works perfectly for what I want to do, so maybe it'll work for you as well. Well, thank you all for watching. If you have any questions or comments, go ahead and post them down below this video.
Well, that's all I've got for today. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to like it by giving it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, click the bell notification button, and I'll see you again very soon.